Evening, dear women. First, we're going to bless because this is Rosh Chodesh, the eve of Rosh Chodesh Nisan v'Shah Tova. Bezot Hashem, shiyam nubsorot tovot, shebezot Hashem yegi Mashiach, tzidkenu b'mra b'menu, amen. Yegi mevasar Eliyahu Nabi, Eliyahu Tishbi, Eliyahu Gledin, b'mra b'nu Mashiach, ben David, Eliyahu Nabi, zachur l'tov. Nashim yekarot, dear women, listen carefully. This Shabbat, you will see that the portion of the week is Metzorah. Leprosy. Okay, this Shabbat we are reading from Chumash Vayikra, the portion that is called Metzora Leprosy. And if you remember, you can look again at TorahAnytime.com. You can look over there the portion of the week, which is Leprosy Metzora, and you'll find everything that you need over there. I will just remind you, it's about Lashon Hara. Everything, it's about the things that God does to the house in the land of Israel, then the clothing, and then the skin of a human being that he makes him have the sickness that is called leprosy, tzaraat. Now, we are going to speak today, this is what I'm going to tell you about the parasha. If you want to see more, go to TorahAnytime.com and then look under my name at the parasha. And I would like to tell you, today we're going to be, the whole lesson is going to be Bli Neder, about Hilchot Pesach. The Jewish laws of Passover. First of all, the week before Passover, which is next week, the Shabbat before Passover, is called Shabbat HaGadol, the big Shabbat. Shabbat, it's called next week, it will be Shabbat HaGadol. Okay? Next week, it's Shabbat HaGadol. It's very important. Why is it called Shabbat HaGadol? Because I would like to tell you, when the Jewish people went out of Egypt, before they went, the Passover was on Thursday. B'yom Chamishi, it was on Thursday. And Yud B'Nisan, the 10th of Nisan, was Shabbat. It was the Yud of Nisan, because then Thursday is already Passover. Yud B'Nisan Ayah Shabbat. God told them to do a big mitzvah and to take a lamb, a sheep, and to put it and to tie it to their beds. Also, you have it in the portions of the week. I already told you all the story, but I'm reminding you so you'll understand what is Shabbat HaGadol. I'm giving you only a few explanations about it, because we have to go quickly as much as we can to cover today. So, it says that God told them, take a lamb and just tie it to your bed. And then he said, on the fourth day, 4 days you have to have it, and on the fourth day you have to slaughter it. This is the sacrifice of Passover. Ze Korban Pesach. This is exactly the sacrifice of Passover. And I would like to tell you, dear women, why did he ask the Jewish people to do that? Because they were Aron ve'Ariah. Aron ve'Ariah, Aron ve'Ariah means that they were naked of mitzvot. They did not have any mitzvah. They didn't have anything. They were inside 49 gates of impurity. So God wanted them to give them a mitzvah. That's why it's written by the Nevi'im, by the prophets, Bedamaich Chayi. It's written Pamaim, Bedamaich Chayi, which means you're going to live by your blood. What blood? And twice it says, you know, it repeats itself twice. Why? Because the first blood was the blood of the lamb, of the sheep. Okay, this is the first blood. And the second one was the blood of Brit Milah, circumcision that they had. Moshe Rabbeinu and Aaron, they had to circumcise all of the men of Israel, except for the tribe of Levim, that they were already circumcised. But they stopped doing the Brit Milah. And you are not allowed to eat from the Korban Pesach without being Mahul, without having Brit Milah. So they were circumcised, and you know from Avraham Avinu that it takes 3 days in order to heal. You remember Avraham Avinu was sitting, he waited for his guests for 3 days. It says three angels came. Rashi says we know by that the three angels came, 3 days passed. So it took them, they did the Brit Milah, 3 days, fourth day they slaughtered the sheep. And why did they do that? So one mitzvah was the mitzvah of Milah. But the second one, once they did, they took the sheep and they tied it to their bed. You know that the Egyptians were worshipping the sheep. They were worshipping the lamb. Taled, Mazal Taled, they were worshipping it. So they came and asked them on Shabbat, why are you having the sheep next to you? And it was a male sheep without any blood on it. Blimum. They asked them, why did you put the sheep next to your bed? They said, because God told us to slaughter it after 4 days. Now you can imagine that when you tell a person that worships an animal and you tell them that you're going to slaughter it, they will come in and want to kill you. So instead, they were so afraid from the Jewish people, from the children of Israel, they couldn't do anything. It says in the Midrash that angels came to protect the children of Israel. And the Bechorot, the firstborns of the Egyptians, came, already heard what is going to happen. They came to Paro, he was also a firstborn. And they came to him and said, you have to let them go. And Paro said, no, I'm not going to let them go. So they started killing the Egyptian people. Yes. Yeah, then themselves. So there were a lot of miracles on that Shabbat. That's why that's part of the reasons why it's called Shabbat HaGadol. Now, once they did this, once they took the sheep and put it next to their bed, they showed that they trust Hashem. They have true belief in Hashem. That they are doing exactly what he told them, and then they are willing to die for the sake of the name of God. Do you understand? So now, instead of being empty of mitzvot, they don't have any mitzvah. Now they do have. One is Brit Milah, and the other one is Korban Pesach. So they have two mitzvot, which because of those two mitzvot, the Nevi'im say, Bedamai Chayi, you're going to live by the blood twice, because those are two mitzvot that are connected to blood. Okay, and why is it connected to blood? Because blood is the nefesh, is part of the soul. I told you, in the blood, there's the lowest part of the soul. So this is also part of it. And there's another thing. It's the Aftara on that day is from Malachi. It's from the book of Malachi, Peregimim, the third chapter, the book of Malachi. And it says over there, from the book of Malachi, I will give you the quote. It says, "Hina anochi sholeach lachem et Eliya hanavi lifno b'yom Hashem hagadol v'anora." I'm going to send you Eliyahu Hanavi before the day of judgment, before the big day, he says. I'm going to send you Eliyahu Hanavi. So it's written, Yom Hashem HaGadol V'anora. That's why it's also called Shabbat HaGadol. Exactly by the Haftarah that they're going to read Bezrat Hashem on that Shabbat. It's next Shabbat. It's not this Shabbat. It's the next Shabbat Bezrat Hashem. Another thing we call, because nobody asked me over here, why isn't it called, maybe, no, but there are people who know Hebrew here. Why isn't it called Shabbat HaGdola? In a male tense. In a female instead of a male, because this is Shabbat. It's supposed to be Shabbat HaGdola. But it's a Gadol because of the Haftarah, because it's Yom HaShem HaGadol. So they took it, it's Yom HaShem HaGadol. This is the big day of Hashem of God, which I'm going to send you Eliyahu HaNavi. That's why it's written HaGadol, just like the Haftarah. And it's a minhag, it's a custom that on that Shabbat, usually the rabbi in the shul gives a big lecture about Passover, about the miracles that Hashem did to the children of Israel. And because the rabbi is, you know, rabbi, it stands for Rosh Bnei Israel. Rabbi, you see Reish, Bet, Yud, it's a rabbi. It's the head of the children of Israel. That's why it's also called Shabbat HaGadol, because he stands and gives a big lecture on that Shabbat Bezrat Hashem. So dear women, you know, next week, Bezrat, not this week, next week Bezrat Hashem, Shabbat Abba, it's called Shabbat HaGadol. Tell your children, so they should be reminded and go to the shul and listen, Bezrat Hashem, to your rabbis, Bezrat Hashem. Now let's start. Now we are standing mamash lifnei Pesach. We are starting now. We passed Shabbat HaGadol. You know that the eve Monday at the eve of Monday is already Pesach. Is already Pesach because Yudalet Nisan is on Monday. Yudalet Nisan is on Monday, so the eve of Pesach is Monday night because this is Tetvav already. So dear women, listen. Now we're going to Bdikat Chametz. We are going to check for chametz and biur. It's very important. The halachot regarding dikat chametz. We are showing chametz. You know, we have chametz and matzah. One can look chametz. And we have matzah. You can see that the two words, chametz means bread, everything that... איך קוראים לזה באנגלית? נו, איך קוראים לזה? לא, 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 יסט. ליבן? Leaven, it's called? Ken, leaven. How do you pronounce it? Leaven?
Leaven.
Leaven. Okay. So chametz is leaven. It's very important. That's chametz. And look at the matzah. But look at the letters. You see that matzah and chametz have the same letters. Look. Mem you have over here, and mem you have over here. And tzaddik you have over here. Over here. And then the only difference is chet and hey. It's the clue. The only difference between chametz and matzah in the Hebrew language is only chet and hey. You see? The matzah has hey and the chametz has chet. I can give you a whole lecture only about this. It's a beautiful thing, but I won't stop on it, but it's beautiful. I will just tell you, it's part of Tehillim. It's a part of what King David said. It's part of Tehillim. It's Perek Samechet. Tavili te Perek Samechet. Ken, Perek Samechet. It's beautiful, but I will just give you a small hint about it. It's written over there, Ge'ar Chet Kaneh. Okay. הנה יש לי סיגלית הביאה לי. הביאה לי נשמה, תודה. סמכת, 68. It's chapter 68. And on chapter 68, just a minute. רק רגע, נמצא את הפסוק בפנים. הנה. Chapter 68, verse 31. It's written גאר חיית קנה. Look. It's written גאר. Haya Kane. It's the 31. It's chapter 68. Samechet. It's Tehillim. It's Tehillim. Chapter Samechet, Pasuk 31. Lamedalim. Okay. It's the beginning of the pasuk. Now, if you look, Gar Chayat Kane. If you look, you can read it. Gar Chet Kane. Which means God was angry with the letter chet. And why was he angry? Because of her mouth, of a kane, of her, the mouth of the of letter chet. So you see, it's beautiful. You ask him, how come? What is the problem of God with the letter chet?
Explain
it. Gaal chet kane, which means God was angry. Gaal in Hebrew means angry. Chet with the letter chet. And what he told her, kaneh, he needs a kaneh, the mouth of the letter chet. Now, what was the problem of God with the letter chet? Kaneh is כמו גרון, זה פתח.
I'm sorry.
31, you see it? 68, chapter 31.
מה זה
הקנה
של הרוב חץ? 31. Okay, dear women, you found it? Quickly, and I want to go back. Listen, dear women, it's very important. So it says, why would God be angry with letter chet? What is chet? Chet, listen very carefully. Chet, as you pronounce it, is a sin in Hebrew. Chet is sin. If you put the whole letters, when you write chet, without, not only the letter, but the way you pronounce it, chet in Hebrew is a sin. So God told the letter chet, You're very harsh with my children, it says. You're very harsh with them because once they sin and you have the letter chet, look what happens. They don't have anywhere to go, only, God forbid, to hell. Down. They cannot find a way to do tshuva with the letter chet. They cannot find a way of doing tshuva with the letter chet. So God told her to open him another path, another pit. So where did he open? He said to her, don't close totally this side. And what do we get? Hey! The chet became hey. Because he opened this path, you see? God told her, open kaneh, open a path, a passage. In order that if someone wants to do tshuva and he's already sinning, he's in chet, but he's sinning, he will see that there's a place that he can go through and do tshuva. So this is the difference between chet and hey. Look how beautiful it is. Do you understand, dear women? The chet of chametz and the hey of matzah. Because the chet of what is chametz? Chametz is yetzer hara, the shor shebaisa. It's the yetzer, it's the bad spirit. It's the yetzer hara, it's Satan itself. This is chametz. Why is it chametz? Why do we call it chametz? Because chametz rises, which means when we bake bread, okay, when we bake bread or we do cakes, okay, it starts to rise. And when we say it starts to rise, it means that we can compare that to a human being that thinks that kochi ve'otzem yadi asali d'chay l'zeh, that it's me, because of my hard work, I succeeded in life. He does not remember Hashem. So what happens? He becomes proud. He has, and when you become proud, you know, your chest becomes wider. Yeah, you breathe it because you, and then you straighten yourself because you become. It's exactly like the chametz. So God says, take the chametz out of your hearts. You should bury that chametz out of your heart, and then you should be just like the matzah. Just like the matzah, you have to be modest, like the matzah. We do not let the matzah, otherwise it's chametz. We do not let the matzah to rise. We do the dough quickly. We take a fork and we make holes in it. And before 18 minutes, yes, we put it in the oven in order that it won't rise. So we will learn from the matzah to be humble. The children of Israel, when they went out of Egypt, they were very humble. They listened to Hashem. They went out only with matzah. They knew that they're going to the desert. They didn't have food with them. But they trusted Hashem. They had a true belief, a true emunah. They trusted Hashem. They trusted Hashem that He will provide for them everything. They did not ask questions. So this is the same thing. Now we have to do to check the chametz at home. So, dear women, let's start. We have to check the chametz. We have to burn the chametz out of our hearts, not only to burn it physically, but also spiritually to burn the chametz. And then we also have to sell the chametz from our homes. Mechirat chametz. We have to do a selling of a chametz. So let's start. First of all, we have to check the chametz. On the evening, it's Sunday. Sunday night, it's the evening of the 14th of Nisan. Okay?
כן,
אני אגיד לכם בדיוק, אני רשמתי לכם הכל. בדיקת חמץ, by the, listen dear women, by the calendar of Chabad, I took it from the calendar of Chabad, you check the חמץ on the evening of, it's Sunday night, is ערב יודלד, the 14th of Nisan, okay, this Sunday, this coming Sunday, you have to start checking the chametz at 8, 11,
this Sunday, next Sunday.
No, not this Sunday, the Sunday before Passover. Okay, you understand.
It's the 17th?
17th
of April.
17th of April, okay, April 17th. It's a Sunday. Dear women, listen, on the eve of the 17th of April, which is the eve of the 14th of the month of Nisan, not this week, next week, it's a day before Passover, we have to check for chametz. This is Bdikat chametz. We do that exactly after Arvit, when the men daven Arvit in the shul, immediately after that they do Bdikat chametz. Now, we have a small thing that collects the chametz, and then we have a feather, and we go by the light.
In Judaica, they have it, it costs $1.99, yeah. Three pieces. It's a candle, of a honey candle, with a feather, spoon. And as well the wooden spoon. Where you collecting, especially. And then $1.50, it's cost, I just bought it today, that's what I know. They have already prepared bread. How many pieces? It's already wrapped in a plastic to give out. It's so cute. I just went for kids, so they're gonna enjoy it. It's a very nice experience.
What we do when the men come, it's beautiful. It should take your children to do that with your husbands. If you are not married and you live alone, or you are divorced, or you are a widow and you live alone, you have to do the mitzvah, okay? Women have to do that mitzvah. Even if you are alone, you have to do the mitzvah of bdikat chametz ve-biur chametz, and also to burn the chametz. How do we do that? We take for it. You have to check in all of the places and all of the corners that there can be chametz. Just check all over. But you do that with a candle, ner shava. You take a candle, and you have to go in each corner and check. And you say the blessing. The blessing is this. You say, Baruch ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech Haolam, Asher Kidshanu Mitzvotav Vetzivanu Al Bi'ur Chametz, which means we are blessing to remove all of the chametz. Now, listen, dear. In order that this law, Bi'ur Chametz, Efeshaz, good question. Shoshana asked a wonderful question. In the blessing, we say Bi'ur Chametz, which means already burning the Chametz. Ki Bi'ur in Hebrew is Lisrot the Chametz. We do not say Bdikat Chametz. Why? Because the goal is to burn the Chametz. The checking is not the goal. That's why we already bless about Bi'ur Chametz, okay? Now, in order that the blessing won't be in vain, maybe we won't find anything. In order that it won't be in vain, we prepare, you know, crumbs of bread. We put it either in an aluminium folded, little pieces, 10 pieces. You write where you put it so you won't forget, okay? Because then the husband checks for it. And maybe you'll forget already because of the children and everything, you'll forget where you put it. So as a woman, write where you put the 10 pieces of bread, small pieces, covered, of course. Okay, don't leave them like that. Covered, and then let your husband and the children check for the chametz. It's fun for the family. Ken, it's a beautiful tradition, and the children love it. And this is a part of giving them the tradition of the Jewish people. Yes. They can put it, but just write yourself where you put it. Just know where you put the bread, okay?
I want to ask you something. I live in an apartment and we have a house. It's building. It's almost an hour. The Goyim people, you know, when they do their stuff, they eat. Should we also like clean up, like sweep and do the... They're looking for the chametz.
But they are still going to work in during Passover there?
Not in the Chalmah. I don't know.
You don't know. You have to ask the rabbi. Yeah, I don't know if you need to do that. You have to ask the rabbi. You do not live there physically.
I know.
But they did not finish building it. No, they did not finish building it. That's why she has to ask. If it's yours, like a store or something, you have to. But no, this is in process of building. So even though it's hers, but it's still in process, and there will be going over there and they will leave. You have to ask a rabbi, okay? Because it's a specific question. לא משנה, אבל זה הרכוש שלה. מבינה, זה כמו שיש חנות או שיש קליניק או משהו, אז את חייבת לנקות כי זה רכוש שלך. אבל פה בגלל שזה בשלבי בנייה ועדיין יהיו שם גויים שיבנו, אז היא חייבת לשאול את הרב מה עושים עם זה. אלא אם כן כאילו מוכרים את כל מה שיש שם למישהו, לרב כאילו בתור חמץ. You have to ask the rabbi, okay? Okay, let's continue. After we found... We found the pieces, the crumbs of the pieces that we left and pieces that we did not leave. We found and we cleaned everything, Be'ezrat Hashem. We say during the check, and also when we are going to burn the chametz, we have to say this. It's written in Aramaic, but you say it in the language that you understand, because you have to understand the meaning. It says like this: Kol chamira vechamia deika birshuti dela chamitei udela biartei udela yedana lea levatil vlea veafker keafra diara, which means every chametz, everything that is a chametz that is in my possession, which means in my house where I am, it's in my possession, that I did not find it. I did not find it. And I did not burn it because I couldn't find it. It says, and I did not know that it's there because I didn't find it, which means I don't know that it's there. Then it should be hefker, which means it's like it does not exist. Okay? It will be exactly as dust of the earth because it does not exist. I did not see it. It does not exist anymore.
And if, I'm sorry, if we see it during the Pesach,
then you do have to, say a blessing to take it and to burn it.
Really?
Yes, it's halacha. It's like it's also Shulchan Aruch. Okay.
If it's more, if we cannot, there was something that took place in the Pesach, during the Pesach, I found it, and I didn't know that it was there, so I swear it was covered everything.
I'll show you the halacha. And I have a blessing I'll show you. It's in Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. I'll give you the halacha. I will go to it in a, just a minute. I don't want to take time. I would like to continue. Just remind me at the end, okay? Because there is a special halacha about it. Bdikat chametz. Rak shnia. Wait. It says Matzah Chametz by Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. I know you're explaining to each other with this in the same language, but listen, dear women, it's important. If you find Chametz in your house on Chol HaMoed, you should take it out and burn it. This is from Shulchan Aruch. Okay, and if it is the quantity of the kazai, you should first say the bracha.
And if it's a lot, then...
Anyway, you have to take it out and the ba'erotot, the misrofot, anyway, if it's more than kazai, you say the bracha and burn it.
Can we give it to the goy?
No.
And you have to burn it. It's not for all, you can't give it to a goy. It's a beim etzah beyom tov. It's important. It's a good question. They asked. Listen very. You know, each house. אני אענה לשאלות. אני אענה קודם. אני תקשיבו כי זו שאלה טובה. Then you ask again and then listen to the question was excellent. She asked. Shoshana asked. What happens if I see chametz during Pesach? During Yom Tov or Chol HaMoed, what do I do? So listen, first of all, you know that if you have a cupboard or you know in the basement somewhere that you put chametz and you close it, you sell it to the rabbi. You go to the rabbi, you sell it as a special form that you sign that you sold all the chametz in your house and you sign it. If you are not going to stay at home for Passover, you do that instead of on the 14th, you go to the rabbi on the 13th of Nisan. And you sign over all the chametz because you won't be at home. So either you do that or you send a messenger in your name, b'shluchos shel adam kmoto. Okay? You send a messenger and you sell all of the chametz that you have in your home. Now what happens, not in the places that you sold, but you are in the house and... Yes. But you're in the house and you saw chametz. You just missed it, I don't know, but you saw it on Passover, on Yom Tov. So this is what the halacha from Kitzur Shulchan Aruch says.
You sold out already, it's also.
No. What you sold, because what you sold, you already closed it in cupboards and you said it chametz, nobody touches it, you sold it. What happens after you checked, but there's a place that you didn't check, but there's a chametz, and dafka. Bepesach on Chol HaMoed on Yom Tov, you see that in front of your eyes. So what do you do? So Halacha says like this: Matzah chametz bebeto bechol haMoed. If you found it when it was Chol HaMoed, Yom Tzien b'Yisrof, and you take it out and you burn it. Okay, this is by Halacha. Ve'im yesh bo kazayit, if it's kazayit, you remember it's like 30 grams, more than crumbs, like it's 30 grams. יברך מתחילה על ביור חמץ. You have to bless again ביור חמץ. אבל על פחות מכזית לא יברך. If you have less than כזית, you do not bless. Okay? כזית is approximately 30 grams. Okay? You remember. ואם מצאו ביום טוב או בשבת חול המועד, if you found it on יום טוב, or on שבת of חול המועד, like, do we have שבת of חול המועד? When we have Passover. וכן בשבת שחל בערב פסח, ואיסור לטלטלו משום דבי מוקצה, יכפה עליו כלי עד מוצאי יום טוב ומוצאי שבת ואז ישרפנו. Which means, if you saw it on יום טוב You take a cup or something, not a see-through, and you put it on it. And then if you're starting on Yom Tov, on Shabbat of Chol HaMoed, you put it on it, and when Shabbat goes out, you burn it. Okay? If it's more, if it's kazait and more, you say the blessing and you burn it. But if it's less than kazait, you just burn it, okay? Without the blessing. Okay? Yes.
Let's say to go to the supermarket, like No.
First of all, the chametz of goyim is okay because it's not yours. It's not yours, it's a goyim. Even if you see a goyim eat chametz in front of you, it's not an avera, it's not yours. Okay? It shouldn't be in your home, in your place, in your hearts. You understand? The Jewish people in your hearts, in your home, where you live, where your shop is. Those things.
It is true that we cannot buy eggs during the... You have to buy all your eggs, whatever you need, on the Passover, before Passover starts.
It's better to buy before. If you have a problem, you could buy from a Jewish person, a Jewish store. Can, but if you can't, try to make all of the things that you need to buy before Passover. Okay, let's continue. Efani. Okay, now when the time to burn the chametz, it's very important. We won't have time to continue. The time to burn the chametz is before 11, which means on Monday, this is Sunday, Erev, the night of Yudalet Nisan is Sunday, but then Monday at 11:47, I think. 11:47 a.m. is the time to burn biur, to burn the chametz. Okay? You eat chametz on Monday, not this coming, but next Monday. You eat chametz until 10:40. 10:40 a.m. you stop eating chametz on Monday. 10:40 a.m. you stop eating chametz. 11:45 is you are burning the chametz. Okay?
לפסח?
אחרי שגמרת הכל, בטח.
כן.
בטח.
שאת
עשית את החמץ. בטח, את יכולה כן. את יכולה, את ביארת לבריאות. הרי את משאירה רק מקום קטן שאת עושה בו לחמץ. רק מקום קטן. כבר הכל מוכשר, התנור מוכשר, הכל מוכשר. בטח, זה כבר גמור. זה כבר...
רגע. יש פה שאלה.
כן.
את אומרת שבאותו יום אפשר
להעביר.
אם אני עושה סלט לפני שבת,
שנייה.
אם זה מקום...
לשבת ערב, חג, שני בערב?
Dear women, we listen to Adina's question. את יכולה להכין, אם המקום כשר וכבר מוכשר ואת מכינה ויש לך מקום לשים במוכשר, כן, את יכולה לעשות. אוקיי, dear women, כי הביאור חמץ, it's כבר all ready to listen very carefully. On the day of ביאור חמץ, until midday, which means 12 o'clock, okay, the men have to be after mikveh, tisporet, they cut their hair, because you know, then the Sfirat Omer, the first day of Pesach, first day of Passover, we say Birkat Atal. Listen, dear women, we say Birkat Atal, which means, until now we bless that there will be rains. Now we bless over the tal, dove, okay? So, Now we bless over the dew. The first day of Musaf, of Shacharit, של Pesach, we say, the first day of Passover, we say Tfilat Atal, okay? And then instead of saying Mashiv Aruach Morid HaGeshem, we say Morid Atal. And then, dear women, at that night, which is the eve of Tetzayin, the 16th of Nisan, we start Sfirat HaOmer. So we can't get haircuts. Sfirat HaOmer, so the counting of the Omer starts. So you have to get your haircuts before the midday of Biur Chametz, exactly Monday, okay? All of those things have to be finished. It says it's not good to do melacha, to do any work after 12. But women still cook for Passover, so this is something else. Don't forget that on that day, on the day of Biur Chametz, there's Ta'anit Bechorot, the firstborns fast.
Boy,
okay.
Only?
Okay. Boy, only the boy. Only boys, the first men. No, boys, men. We mean the male.
Yeah, after 12.
If they go into the shul in the morning, then
yes.
They come, they send.
Okay, and they, what happens, what do? But usually the rabbis see that they will finish Masachtot exactly on the morning of Passover, you know, the morning that is the eve of Passover, and then they are allowed to eat Sudat Mitzvah, because they have to. That's what usually they do. Oh, if there's a Sudat Milah, Brit Milah, then they, exactly, Siyum Masechet. Okay, let's continue. Don't forget to go to your rabbi to sell the chametz. On the time of Biur Chametz, there should be all of the chametz on your house is sold already, okay? There's a special shtar to do a mechira. You have to sell the chametz and to see that everything is sealed and not in front of your eyes. Now, don't forget that, and I wanted to say something. Usually microwaves, when you, if you try to make them kosher for Passover, it's ipsar. You cannot do that usually. There are a few tips that rabbis do say, but I can tell you that most of them will tell you not to use the microwave during Passover, because it's very hard to make it kosher at Pesach. So if you can, ki mod kashe, afilu sheze kacha, ze nichnas ha'edim, hem nisharim badafnot, ve'bekol mine pinot, which means the vapors of the food, of the chametz, is in all of the corners. Even though it's from plastic or in metal inside the microwave, it's still very hard to clean it. So if you can avoid it and don't use the microwave, okay? The oven, it's not no problem. You just need to clean it. Most of the ovens have self-cleaning. Okay, so there's no problem. You can clean it. No. By itself. זה ממש ליבון, זה אש יוצאת מזה. סליחה? כן, אמור להיות. אמור לא לשים את זה. ואם את שמה, את צריכה לשים לפחות מים קודם, אז לנקות את זה מהעדים של הבשרים. אם את רוצה להשתמש, לדעת לשים מקליות של נייר בפנים, וצריך לדעת איך לעשות את זה. Yes, I use the oven. Yes, I put it on self-cleaning. And I use only on the top of the oven. You have to clean very well. Mamash tzach nakot, and then put the aluminium on it, okay? And if you have an oven that has glass on the top,
yeah,
you should change the glass. It's better. I'll tell you why. Because it's very hard to clean the you know, the sritot.
Yeah.
You know,
scratches
on the glass.
No,
and sometimes it's very hard to see the chametz, to take the chametz out. So it says if you can, you'll try to clean it as much as you can. But if you can,
but
if you have
another one, you know, they're selling in the store.
Yes,
exactly, in the oven you put in.
Exactly.
And this foil, you know, it's
yes.
Beautiful.
So you can buy and put it on, and Bezat Hashem, everything will be exactly. It will be okay. לא הבנתי, עוד פעם.
נגיד, אין פלטה. אני לא, נגיד, לא שמה את הפלטה, ושמה רק את הפלט מלמעלה.
איזה פלט? אם את מכסה את יכולה להשתמש. כן, ואת מכסה, זה מה שאמרתי להם, לכסות את זה. גם אם מנקים, even if you clean it. put on it aluminium foil or something in order to be sure that nothing will touch it, even if there's a crumb on it, I don't know what is over there. את שמה מסביב, אבל אפשר לקנות את זה, את ממש מלבישה על זה מסביב. את שמה מסביב לזה, את מנקה את זה טוב, את מלבנת את זה גם, באש ממש מנקה את זה, את הכל הכל לשרוף, את כל החלקים. You even burn it. I know we are speaking about the oven. You have to burn it even with fire around, you know, the places that when you have a pot and everything sometimes goes around it, you have to clean very well. So זה נקרא ליבון, by fire, ואז מנקים את כל החריצים, everything you have to clean very well to see that nothing is inside, and then you can put aluminium foil around it.
Yeah.
Okay? That's what you do. So the sink
inside, you know, because you have a stainless steel,
yes, and then you can buy something to put it on it.
There's a special cover for the sink. I have a special cover so you can open it and change the filter.
So you'll change the filter?
No, I cannot open it.
But it's only water over there, nakhon? Only water.
Nothing goes inside.
So it's not supposed to be a problem. Just clean it from the outside and let water go out of it, but it's okay. It's like a shraya to do, okay? Oh, don't forget, dear women, to check all... Shh. Don't forget... to check when you buy food that is kosher for Passover.
Yes.
Look at everything that you buy, that you have it. You, if it's OU, it has to be P. See that it's kosher for Passover, because sometimes you can make mistakes. So check everything that you buy. Now I would like to tell you, dear women, we have three kinds of matzot. The first one is called matzah regilah, regular matzah. And then we have matzah shmura. When you hear, just when you hear the expressions, you will know what they are talking about. We have matzat mitzvah, a mitzvah matzah. We have matzah shmura, okay, which is called, I translate the guarded matzah, matzah shmura. And then you have a regular matzah. The difference between matzah shmura, a guarded matzah, and matzah regular matzah, the only difference is from when do the rabbis check the process of preparing the matzah. When you have matzah regular matzah, they check everything after the harvest is in and everything is now starting to be, they grind the grains, then they check everything. But matzah shmura starts when they start to harvest everything, okay? That's the difference. Now, the matzat mitzvah is the matzah that we eat on the first, and in exile, on the two days of the Passover. In Israel, it's one day. Here we have 2 days that we do the Seder. So don't forget, here we do 2 days the Seder. We do it on Monday night and on Tuesday night, because this is Yom Shani Shel Galiot, the second day of exile, okay? Don't forget, 2 days they are Seder. Yom Shani Shel Galiot. One day, of course. Israel, only one day. Only in exile, you have to be 2 days. Israel, they have more Chol HaMoed. We don't have it. Okay, let's continue. So matzat mitzvah is the matzah that we eat on the days of Passover, the day of the Seder, the 2 days of Seder. That's matzah shmura, matzat mitzvah also called. Okay, matzat mitzvah, because the two mitzvot that we have on Passover, there are two mitzvot, the oraita, from the Torah, the written Torah. The two mitzvot are, first of all, that we will eat matzah, that we will eat the matzah, and the second one, that we will tell the story of the egg of the Yetziat Mitzrayim to our children. Vigata lebanecha. So those are the two of the seder.
Reading by the turn, and keeps taking the turn, everybody's reading. This way everybody participates, everybody understands.
It's good, you know, to remember everything that we spoke about Yetziat Mitzrayim, Exodus. Just, you can look on the net and look at the stories, and you can say that on the table of the Seder. So we'll have a big merit from that. It's a big zchut.
Okay,
אני רוצה להמשיך רגע.
A lot of people Pesach in New York, Agadah, once only. Whoever lived in Israel, they have a house in Israel. Now, we kept one only, but it was mistake. And we were told like that.
No,
it has to be anyway to Agadah, right?
Anyone who lives in exile more than 12 months, even if he has a house in Israel, has to do Passover 2 days.
2 days.
Okay? This year it's Monday night and Tuesday night. I was born, it doesn't matter. No. Only if you're a guest, you came and you're 3 months here and you're going back, that's something else. Okay, let's continue, Banot. I would like to tell you, to remind you, on the second day of Passover, we start the counting of the Omer. They're explaining to them, I understand. Yes, exactly. So don't forget to take your children to cut their hair, to explain to them, to them, Spirat HaOmer. It's very important. I know they're explaining, that's why it's very hard. Yeah, you know what? To translate in a few, Leah, 1 minute, let me finish because we want to go. I would like to tell you, we are reading Megillat Shir HaShirim. We are reading Shir HaShirim that King Solomon wrote on Shabbat of Chol HaMoed. Shabbat of Chol HaMoed, after the davening of Shacharit, before we open the book of Torah, we say Shir HaShirim. Okay, and I already told you once that Rabbi Akiva said, all the songs are holy, but Shir HaShirim is the holiest of holies. And it speaks about the engagement of God to the children of Israel and the four exiles that we are in. So, dear women, we read Shir HaShirim. And there's a custom, you'll see a lot of Agadot, that at the end of the Seder, you'll see at the end of the Agadah, Shir HaShirim. There's a custom in a lot of places to read Shir HaShirim at the end of the Agadah. You'll see it in the Agadah. Usually sporadic people say the Shir HaShirim at the end of the Agadah. And
in the Seder?
Besof HaGadah Shir HaShirim. Besof HaGadah. Ken, אבל לפני יש בשיר השירים או אחריהם יש שיר השירים, תראי. בדרך כלל יש את זה ואומרים את זה. Another thing, dear women, wait, don't forget we have 4 cups. Okay, I have to finish, but I'll tell you something. You want... Ma? Okay, don't forget that you have to sit lying down like this on your left side, even though it's important. Everybody should sit down when he has a little bit of, you know, angle towards his left side, hasava. Why sitting like kings? Because now we are free. And why is it important? It's important. It's important, dear women, because this symbolizes the freedom from going out of Egypt as slaves and then going out to be free people. If you are not right-handed and you are left-handed, you'll ask me, so do I need also to lie down on the left side? Yes. Even though you're left-handed, even though you have to lie on the left side, okay? Everybody has. It doesn't matter if you write with your right hand or your left side. This is halakha. You have to put it, you have to have an angle in the situation towards, lean to low, towards the left side. The last thing that I want to remind you is the Kara of Pesach. We didn't have enough time, but at least this, the Kara of Pesach. You know, the plate. By the calendar of Chabad, okay? I took the hours from the calendar of Chabad. You finish eating chametz at 10:40. It's a mitzvah to eat chametz on that day. Do you understand? Yes.
Doesn't matter who will be burning, wife, kids, husband.
If your husband cannot burn, you should burn it, okay? Or your son.
But not daughter.
Your daughter can go also if you give her the right to go to the rabbi. Usually what happens, we go to the rabbi, he has a small place to burn the chametz. Uh-huh. So he will say the blessing. We are your tzeb, that we hear him say the blessing.
But Rabbi never say blessing where we're burning. Never, there are no rabbi in shul yard. They have special blessing.
So you do that, and then you have to say, I told you what you say. So each one of you says that. Okay? Here, I'll show you. It's also in English. Okay, let's at least the plate. And let's go to say the blessing of the Ilanot because it's also Chodesh Nisan.
When the Pesach is over, when you are allowed to be
blessed. It is like that, more of like Chodesh the God name.
Sorry?
Oh,
tomorrow is Rosh Chodesh. And yes, and tomorrow we're davening in the shul. We're saying Shacharit and Musaf Rosh Chodesh. Thank you. So the name of God for the month of Nisan is exactly Yud Kei Vav Kei. Yismechu Hashamayim V'Tagel Haaretz. It comes for that pasuk. It's exactly the right name that is written in the Siddur. That's the name of mercy, the full name of mercy. Yud Kei Vav Kei, because this is the month, the first month of all of the months. Rosh HaChodeshim, it's the head of the month, Nisan. The name of God is exactly like it's written in the Siddur. So now you don't have to remember anything. It's written in the Siddur. So don't forget that Musaf of Rosh Chodesh. You will come and you'll say tomorrow, Bezrat Hashem, in the Musaf. You'll say over there, Baruch Atah Hashem, over there. And then when you say, Baruch Atah Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael, Barashel Chodeshim, you say, Baruch Atah Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael, and you remember the name of God exactly like it's written in the Siddur. Okay? It's Yud Kei Vav Kei exactly the same way. I just want to write you the... just want to make you the kara. We have three matzot. You remember? We have three matzot. Shh. The three matzot. One, two, three is parallel to the three fathers, forefathers. Abraham, Yitzchak, Abraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov. And then it's also parallel to Levim. We have Kohanim, Levim, Beisrael. You see? And it also parallel to the Birkat HaKohanim, the triple blessing of the Kohanim, of the high priest. Yevarkecha Hashem v'yishmerecha, yair Hashem panav alecha v'yichuneka, yisa Hashem panav alecha v'yasem lecha shalom. Amen. Because you see, it's Yevarkecha, yair v'yisa. Okay, three blessings. So I'm just giving you a tip of all the things that it symbolizes. And then don't forget the middle matzah, we break, it's part of the afikoman. You remember, it's a big blessing for a good parnasah to take a part of the afikoman and put it in your homes until next Passover. Oh, I forgot there's a big minhag to take the lulav from Sukkot. You will see people and to burn it, bebi'uch hametz. There's a minhag to take the lulav and also the oshanot, the arabot that you do the oshanai with them, to take them and to burn them. There are people that keep them from Sukkot till Passover in order to burn them. Now let's look. אמרתי לכם, יום 11:47 ביום שני בבוקר. בסדר?
Why is that? Remember to take it out and burn it on the
chametz. Yes, the matzah that you had from the last Passover. She's right. Thank you. Yes.
Why is Shmura matzah round and other matzahs are square?
Oh,
square, it's a commercial ones.
The commercial ones are square. There's no the round one is to show a whole thing. You know that
the for nerds and the round.
It's not. You know they used to eat, in the past. They did not used to eat matzot that were commercial. You know there's a special hatarah to eat the commercial matzot because they said that they cannot check the process inside the machines. So they cannot know if a little bit of dough was inside and it became chametz. But then they eventually they did allow to eat the commercial matzot because usually they ate only matzot that were made by hand. That they knew exactly that nothing chametz was in it.
But
the matzah is round exactly like it's a whole. It's you know, there's no beginning and no end to Hashem. It's like infinity. And there's no beginning and no end to the children of Israel because He promised us, Hashem, that we will be Bezrat Hashem forever with Him. There's like a, it's like, Ken, it's like the Torah and it's like a ring. And it's, I know today it's hard because it's Passover and it's halachot and everybody wants to ask questions. It's like a ring, you know, the matzah is around, just like a ring. God, when he erased at Amisal, which means when he was engaged to the children of Israel, so he was engaged exactly with a circle, כמו טבעת, הרי את מקודשת לי, לי סגולה, okay? It's like a ring. So look, dear women, let's start. We have, I will show you also by, we have this. We have the matzot, and over the matzot, the three matzot is against the three counting of the Kabbalah. Okay, Chokhmah.
Sorry, it is a question.
Bina, Bedat. Ken.
יש פה שאלה, האם אפשר שבן אדם גוי יהיה
בבית? לא עכשיו, תדמה בסוף, תביא לי רק את זה לגמור, עוד שנייה, עוד שנייה. עכשיו, יש לנו ככה, we have the Zroa, you remember the Zroa is called, is a shake bone, we have the shake bone, and you remember this is parallel to the sacrifice of Pesach, Korban Pesach, this is the Zroa, we do not eat it on this, in the Seder. But this is what we have over here. Then we have the egg on the other side. The egg is like the egg is like the sacrifice of Chagigah, Korban Chagigah. There are two sacrifices that we give them when we have high holidays. Passover, Shavuot, and Sukkot. The three high holidays, we bring a Korban Chagigah, it's called. So the egg symbolizes the Korban Chagigah. Okay, so this is for Korban Chagigah also. Korban Chagigah. And this is Korban Pesach. Korban Pesach, okay? And Korban Chagigah. The egg also symbolizes Bet HaMikdash, the ruining of Bet HaMikdash. Because an egg symbolizes that everything is round. And the ruining of Bet HaMikdash is just like the egg, because the egg you eat when you are mourning. So that's why we use the egg to remind us about Beit HaMikdash that was ruined, and Bezrat Hashem Yibaneh Bimehra Bimeinu, Amen. Another thing, the egg symbolizes the children of Israel. The more you boil it, the harder it gets. So the more suffering the children of Israel get, Shalom Nidam Etzarot, that we won't have any suffering, but the stronger they get as a nation, as people. Okay, so that's why the egg, it symbolizes. I'm just giving you tips about the things that we have in on the Kara. Then we have Maror. Okay, Maror is lettuce. We take the Maror over there. We usually dip it in Charoset. Just a minute, about Charoset. I will explain. We dip the Maror in the Maror. Is for the suffering of the children of Israel. Dear women, I want to go, we need to go, so please, just a few sentences about each one. So Maror is for the suffering of the children of Israel. We usually dip it in the Charoset. Charoset is kmo charsina. It's like the teat. It's like the cement that they had in Egypt, that they had to do the bricks with the cement. That's Charoset. Usually everybody, every Edah has a minhag how to prepare the Charoset. But usually you have nuts inside, apples, wine, raisins, good things that are inside. It looks like the cement. And you dip the Maror for the suffering that the children of Israel had in the Charoset and you eat it. Okay, and another thing, it reminds us, the Charoset also reminds us of Pitom.
You have to bond the
Yeah, it's over here, that's Zroa. Okay, shake bone is here, that's the Zroa. Yeah, it's the shake bone. This is how you prepare your... the plate should look like this, dear women. This is how the plate should look like, okay? It will be Zroa on this side, on the and then Beitzah, and then Maror, and then Charoset. Dear women, it's important, Leah. אחר כך תסבירי לה, זה חשוב. ככה צריכה לראות הצלחת, אוקיי? תסביר לה. Then we have כרפס. אוקיי. We have כרפס, and at the end we have חזרת. I'll explain both of them. אוקיי? We have חרוסת, כרפס, and חזרת. So, we have the כרפס. The כרפס is usually a green... a plant, a green vegetable from, you know, it's spices usually. I wrote parsley. It can be celery. This is the karpas. Okay, we dip it in salty water. Yes, in salt water. We dip it in salt water again for the suffering of the children of Israel. Then we have chazeret. Chazeret is usually maror merusak, which means the chazeret is usually you take the maror, the lettuce, and you just grind it. Usually that's what you do with the chazeret. And usually you have to the chazeret, the Hillel HaZaken, you remember Hillel? Hillel HaZaken used to likroch, he used to use the chazeret in order to lekricha. You take matzah, you take maror, and chazeret, you korech.
Yeah.
This is the korech, and you put it together, and this is the minhag from Hillel HaZaken. That's what we do with the chazeret. Okay? In general, if you look at the plate, you'll see...
This is horseradish.
Ken,
right?
Horseradish. Ken, that chazeret. You will see over here that if you look at the top part of the keara, you see there's like... If I look at Zohar and make it a dot, and I look at the beitzah, the egg, and make a dot, okay? This is the shake bone and the beitzah, and then we'll take the maror, the lattice, and I'll make a dot. What kind of nikud do we have? Segol. It's the clue, segol. Okay? That's the nikud. This is nikud in Hebrew, the dot. It's called segol. Okay? Over here, let's look again. Charoset. I'll put a dot here, and another one. And then it's another segol. Look. And you know that when we have chesed, the nikud of chesed, like we separated, we have, you remember that Avraham Avinu, chesed Avraham, he's called chesed. He is the measure in Kabbalah of kindness, of mercy, Avraham Avinu. So it's called mercy, chesed. And the nikud that is parallel to Avraham Avinu, to the measure of chesed of kindness, is segol. Is segol. The nikud is segol. Chesed Avraham is segol. The nikud is segol po chesed, which means there's a hint over here that God saved us with mercy because we didn't have enough mitzvot. We didn't have enough clothing. We were aroma varia. We were naked of mitzvot. So God saved us with chesed Avraham, he saved us. This is a parallel to mercy, kindness. And Bezrat Hashem, I will finish over here just telling you that Bezrat Hashem, that God, Benisan Nigalu, Benisan Tidin Ligael. So God, Bezrat Hashem, will have mercy upon our souls and He will save us and bring Mashiach b'mehra b'yameinu, amen. Eliyahu Nevi Zachor Latov, L'olam Yipared Adam Mechaverov, Yidbar Mitzvah, Yachid Barabim, Halacha Kerabim.